this is a good Nebraska team. This is a game when the schedule came out. I've been concerned with it for a long time. They did exactly what I feared they were going to do. They were really struggling to shoot the basketball. And they make their first four in the first media timeout. And Fred's got these guys playing hard. They're playing together. They're unselfish. I thought Derek Walker's defense was outstanding. I think he's one of the best interior defenders in the league. He went right at Kofi early. Obviously, a huge night with on the offensive end for him being 7 of 11. But more importantly, when I think back at this game, I'm going to remember Coleman Hawkins, huge, huge offensive rebound where I think he got two or three right there in a real critical time. And then I'm going to remember the coming out party for Omar Payne. I couldn't be happier for a young man who's worked so hard and stayed with it. And I think he went a 7 or 8 game stretch maybe where he didn't score, but has kept grinding in practice, and he's with Jeff every day. And to step up and impact the game like he did was huge. In a night that I literally kept the best player in the country on the bench the last 4 minutes, and he was that good. And Trent Frazier, I keep running out of superlatives, adjectives. He does what Trent does. 29 points, 38 minutes, one turnover, and then does it on the other end, guarding his tail off. And we all knew that Alonzo Verge, a talented kid, and, he makes everybody better, but I thought Trent's work on him was tremendous. And then obviously the big shots, the big free throws. We've seen that so often from Trent. So all in all, a great team win. I thought also that Luke Goody, Brandon Pajemski, in the first half came in and really gave us a spark in a night where Plummer was a little off. And to be honest, Kofi wasn't his best, but I want to give them a lot of credit for that.
What do you think led to this slow start?
Maybe their energy. I think they hit us with a blitz and transition. I thought that we got a couple of good looks, but again, they've got the third fastest time of possession in the country, and they got going in transition. We took a couple bad shots, missed a couple, and they just got a couple looks in transition. But you expect that from teams at home.
What's your approach been as a staff to keep Omar on the right path, even when things were tough for him the first 2 months?
Yeah, a lot of conversations, and it takes a special character, a type of character, and he has that. I mean, he has just bought in so much with Fletch in the weight room, with Jeff. He's constantly up there watching film, diving in, and Jeff about knocked me out, with one of his punches because he was so excited. And it's rewarding for Jeff to see that young man keep working and have some success on the court and translate it tonight.
Can you discuss after the Maryland game how sort of a foundational piece of what this team is finding a way to win when the shots aren't falling? Is that just another maybe example where things weren't maybe going as planned but come out with a W?
Yeah, I mean, we held them to 2 threes after the first 4 minutes. And they were 4 for 4 and ended up, so they were 2 for 8. I thought we did what we had to do on that end. And again, I thought Luke was huge. Luke had a couple big plays, busted up a couple opportunities. They're a Verge dominant team tonight, in ball screens, and we weren't going to take his ball. But we did a great job, and that was our goal, was to stay at home, make him finish. We were going to let him shoot 25 shots if he wanted to shoot that many. But we didn't want the other guys to get to going at the three-point line.
Brad, we've heard you talk so much about wanting to get old and stay old, and down the stretch, Trent, DeMonte, Jake, big plays. What's the value of having so much experience who have been in situations like this before?
It's a wonderful thing. I've been blessed in my career to win some games, and usually it's those guys that do it. They've got a special freshman. Bryce is special. But for the most part, you don't win big games with freshmen. You win with veterans who don't panic and play in the moment, and we've got a couple of those, and they continue to do that for us.
You had an unexpected bit of coaching when Andre Carella got involved. What did you think of his defensive trends for you, Carella?
He just got, he saw something that one of their players was doing. He didn't like it and said something, and so no big deal.
What do you think that, obviously those guys have been around for a while, but what do you think has turned for you guys that you went from kind of this young team to now just maybe that mental veteran mindset? I know it's been a couple of years since.
Yeah, it's everything you strive for, building a culture. We've had Trent Frazier and Devontae Williams since they were freshmen. We're not a one-and-done program. That isn't us. We're a development program. We recruit to that piece. We've signed three freshmen in this class. And then getting your program to a point where you do have upperclassmen. I tell our freshmen all the time and how blessed they are to be around those veterans and that they can learn from. And that keeps your culture building and running and do everything that they do, because those guys are everything that we want to be about. Throw Kofi in there now as a third-year guy. And that's what building a program is about. It's why can't stand the portal. It is what it is, but it's one thing we're going to try to keep avoiding here is at Illinois is we're going to keep recruiting freshmen and developing them along the way.
As far as the team strategy for defending Kofi in the middle, where does this game rank with the rest of the season?
Derek Walker is really good, and he's strong. He's an upperclassman. He does a great job of playing angles. And I say that, and Kofi got some good looks. Kofi just had a tough time with the ball didn't go down as often as it does. But Kofi's going to have one of those. It doesn't matter where you shoot him from, 4 feet or 19. Sometimes the ball just doesn't go in. But Derek Walker was really good tonight.
You guys didn't have any bench points at halftime. You end up with 12 with Hawkins and Pan. There's more than just scoring. But how much of a punch do you need maybe off the bench for scoring purposes?
Yeah. That's something I always strive for is finding that those bonus pieces off the bench that add, that don't subtract. And obviously, Omar's plus 17 tonight. That's huge. And I look at plus minus more than I do, points or rebounding or rebounds. But, Luke gave us great minutes. Coleman plus 14, that's where you win the game. That's where you win the game with those guys. And tonight they were huge in their contributions.
How tired did you feel Kofi was, and how did you see him strain, so to speak, to fight through that even when he wasn't?
It's really hard to do what we asked Kofi to do. Because we were riding his shoulders pretty good. We were running a lot of actions to him. Derek's really strong. He probably got a little bit of a dose of what people feel like when they have to guard him. Because for the most part, he just wears people out. But I stayed with him a little longer in the second half. I usually try to get him out around the first media, and I stayed with him through that second media. I've got to do a better job of monitoring that. Now, Omar gives me a lot of confidence